Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Kerbal Space Program. I'm your host, Dierce Meggs. Let's go ahead and get started. Let's see here. Let's go for a small craft. So I'm doing a new design here. I get tired of having to stabilize the ships as they take off. And so I came up with an idea. Why not build a giant bullet? And so that is exactly what I'm going to do. Build a giant bullet. This one. No. No. There we go. Be a single man, and if you can guess by the slant of the wings, by the way, you do that by pressing the QWEASD keys to rotate around any of the parts that you like. Sometimes it'll work, sometimes it won't. The idea is that it's going to rotate much like a rifle does, or the bullet of a rifle. And I figure if I put any whatchamacallits on there. Oh wow, this thing's lagging. Lagging something fierce here. Call it UFO. Come on. Damn. Totally not overkill. Get as many of these on here as we can. See how high we can get with this. And then for safety's sake, come on. Turn that off. Or not. There we go. Can't actually grip onto the top of that. That's fine. Just fine and dandy. Can we grip onto the bottom? Does not appear so. Alright, well, we'll turn symmetry back on. That'll have to do. Hopefully it'll stay on there. Aha. Get rid of that. I think a pair of shoes would be plenty to land this thing safely, even with all that attached weight. This is just going to be a short video today. I'm recording it a day early. I have to go out of town for work, and I wanted to get something up. So, yeah. I think it was Lemonsier, or... you guys are going to yell at me because I'm going to get it wrong anyway. Wanted to see me actually build one of the spacecrafts, so that's what I'm doing. Until I have a better idea of what to build, this is what you're gonna get. I've noticed that I get a lot more comments on my Kerbal Space Program. I guess that's what you guys watch for, which is just fine. I happen to think it's probably my weaker of my series. I think I do a little bit better job in the old whatchamacallit, toy soldiers, than I do in this, but you guys will watch what you watch, and doesn't bother me in the least. I'm just letting you know that the commentary on the Kerbal Space Program is, at least in my opinion, not as good. Alright, that should probably do it. I'm just kind of randomly throwing those on anyway. Turn the symmetry off. Rotate. Attach that to the bottom. Move this up as high as I can, right about there. Yeah, right into the ceiling, that's good. We'll save that, and we'll mess with the staging. So, let's add a couple stages here. This will be parachute stage. And we will at least have some of those ignite on the first part. Actually, let's go ahead and drag some more down there. Drag that there. Let's separate these all out, because we might be able to get higher altitudes with spreading these out a bit. That should do. See what we can do with that. Yes, clear the launch pad. Who will be our brave pilot today? We'll know as soon as this decides to load. There we go. Tomp Long Kerman. He's already terrified. He knows that this thing's a death trap. Oh, it's wobbly. Awesome. So no SAS needed here. Just a matter of launching. So, guess we'll get going. Going off to the side, alright. That's fine. Get another stage in there. Just gonna... I don't know how many more stages I have left. Oh, good, that's the end of it. That didn't work as well as I was expecting. Probably because it slanted at the beginning. I might actually need more launching mechanisms. But that'll be a good try for the next one. So what's your apoasis looking like, buddy? Only 10,000 meters, come on! I know you can do better than that. Oh well, we'll watch you spin off into oblivion. Yeah, we'll go ahead and deploy the parachutes. And... that's right, I can't do that unless I'm... actually sitting still. Doo-doo-doo. Guess we'll find out if this number of parachutes is enough to save our brave Kerman friend. Tomp Long. Anytime you want to land. Probably shouldn't have deployed the parachute so soon, but I figured I'd be able to do space center. Yeah, I'm just gonna end this. It looks like it's gonna be able to stop it, so... Vehicle assembly building. Let's go ahead and just get rid of this staging. Give it all the acceleration we can. Alright. And we will detach this and turn on symmetry. The outermost. There we go. See if that works. The reason I'm doing this is so that I don't hit the tower on the way out, because... yeah, I would definitely hit the yellow bit there on the tower. Not, some of those aren't even attached. Wow. Alright, well... let's give this another try, shall we? There we go. Oh. Alright, well, he's still alive. Good luck, buddy. Hey, you still have a parachute, too. Might be enough to, save you. We won't deploy till the last minute, though. The fine people watching this have better things to do. Got some nice tumble going on. Spiraling toward the Earth, or Kerbin. Whatever. Planets. Yeah, I'm really looking forward to the next release. Gonna have all sorts of cool shit, hopefully. ...3,000 meters and falling. So I'm actually recording this while I'm playing, for once. I've been doing that with, Toy Soldiers, but Kerbal Space Program, I usually don't record my voice until afterwards, but... this one I'm recording during, and I'll probably put some music on it, but I couldn't tell you which ones, I haven't picked them out yet. Eh, it's about time for a parachute. Oh yeah, plenty of slowdown. There we go. He's good and safe. Alright. In flight. Vehicle assembly building. So what we want is to better attach everything to the center. Freaking symmetry. No. You know what? Just load my last save on that, would you? Come on. There we go. Oh. And it didn't save the changes. Whatever. I can redo it. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. That didn't appear to do anything. There we go. Okay, so we want to take this crud, move it down here. Take this crud, move it down here. Take this crud, move it down here. Take this crud. Move it all down here, and this stuff, and this thing will move up there because I'm being arbitrary. Alright. See if that does it. Not that I need to throttle up, I don't know why I was doing that. Alright. Ooh, fancy. We lost all of them that time. And not a single parachute left for you, Tomplong. It's alright. Thomplong? Tomplong? You have a stupid name anyway. Goodbye. Okay, here we are with Ronzer, Kerman. Ready for launch. Going to only have 3 of the 5 sets going, and hopefully that will help us not fly apart, at least not right off the bat. Hey, lasting longer than usual. Wait till we're about half drained on those before igniting the others. There we go. I think I ignited them. Yep, you can see up the top here, that one's going. Getting some good spin here. Lots of G-forces. Awesome. Those burned out. We're in a bunch of smoke. Not sure why. Probably just a graphical glitch. And that cut. There we go. 240,000 meters. That's a good trajectory right there. And that will deploy as soon as you come down. Space Center. Awesome. So let's see if we can improve that. Let's see what happens if we take another set of these and put that on there. See if it's just that final set that makes us fly apart. Okay, we ready? We're ready. Hedwig, have fun. It just seems to be that last set that ends up throwing us all off. Also happens to be the ones on the end, because those are the only ones that aren't glowing. Shouldn't be much longer. Looks like it's spinning faster than the FPS can really render properly. Alright, what's our height? Not as high as the last one. Alright then. Prepare your parachute. And we'll see you later. Hello, Miguel. Miguel? Mac-gel? Miguel, I suppose. How are you doing today? We've separated out our staging a little bit more. See if a more sustained burn will get us higher. So when this is about a third out of fuel, right about here, we'll hit the next one. And when it's two-thirds out of fuel, we'll hit the last set. It's right about there. Sets out. Those two are still going. That one's out. And last one. Ooh, 280. Nice. Good job, guys. Prepare your parachute. Now, if only we could just fling these guys out of the orbit with just one of these simple things. Because they move fast. First 2 stages here. And wait a little while to fire these guys, probably. To see if that will get us any higher. Because we got pretty good results with the last one. So let's just try to figure out good timing. Nedmund. Hmm. odd names. So we're not even going to fire these. We're just going to see how high that first set takes us. Not very high at all. Okay, we'll fire those. Let them burn out. I'm hoping that this turns out to be a really cheap way of launching satellites, when the actual, like, career mode gets put in. Alright, how high are we? Hey, that is technically space right there. So, we'll wait till we get into space. So off-camera I tried this with the larger boosters, and I was getting the exact same results, essentially. Just, you know, taking up more room. So I've foregoed their use entirely and just using the small ones. Because they, I don't know if they burn longer, but like I said, I was getting almost the exact same results out of them, so. These guys are coming around, coming back down. Let's try firing it now. You think now? Yeah, I'm thinking now. Ooh, look at that. Come on, Nedman. You can do it. Break the record! I have faith in you, Nedman. Oh, damn! 574,000 meters. Good job, Nedman. Go ahead and prepare your parachutes. Go to the Space Center. Dudlorf Kerman. Well, Dudlorf, are you ready to possibly make history? And by that I mean not going out nearly as far as some of the other ones have. Really, there's nothing historical whatsoever. And we lost a few. Whatever. Less dead weight. We still seem to be flying, and that's one of the advantages of the bullet design. Is that you could lose some engines and it'll still balance out fairly well. Beginning next stage. Oh, it was all of them again, too. Darn it. Well, this one will just delay the next burning until we actually get to the Apoasis. Those guys are coming down. I don't want to fast forward because then I would lose any rotational momentum that I have. I am curious, where is that other spaceship? Oh, there it is. 42 kilometers away. Goodbye. Oh, no, that was somebody else. You were a hell of a lot closer. Dang. Practically hit us. Okay. Getting close. Getting close. We're still facing the direction that we want. Bam. Oh, that was supposed to fire a second ago, damn it. That's gonna throw the whole thing off. Oh well. We'll see where that ends up. Not nearly as good as the other one. Alright. I think that's enough for this evening. Yeah. I hope you all have a wonderful evening.